My name is Michael Scherer-Lorenzen. I'm from the University of Freiburg in Germany, and I'm the coordinator of the Fund of Europe project. I think most of you perceive biodiversity as something valuable, something beautiful and nice. So the variety and the richness of all organisms on Earth and in nature. But beside that aesthetical value of biodiversity, we ask, does biodiversity matter? Does biodiversity has an importance and an influence on ecosystems and how ecosystems work and how ecosystems function? And we want to study that in an ecosystem that capture most of the biodiversity on Earth, that hold the strong stocks in carbon, which are the forests. This topic of research, we call it also functional biodiversity research, has currently been done within the last 20 years or so in small-scale systems like working with microbes or in grasslands. And in those studies, people found that biodiversity is influencing certain ecosystem processes, certain ecosystem functions in a positive way, meaning that, for example, with increasing plant diversity, there's a higher productivity, so more biomass can be produced, there's less incidence of pathogen attack, and so on. And now we ask, can we find these kind of processes and interactions among species leading to those biodiversity effects also in forests? So how could we tackle that question? One approach would be to go out in the forest, search for stands that differ in tree species richness and diversity, and compare them. And actually, this is done in our so-called exploratory platform of the project, where we have selected in total 250 plots or parcels where we can study these questions in six European regions, from the boreal zone in Finland down to the Mediterranean zone in Spain. And in these plots, a whole number of different projects are working. We have a total of more than 20 PhD students doing their work in these plots, bringing all the data together to answer those basic questions. Does tree diversity matter for different ecosystem functions? Another way to test this question is to make tree diversity experiments. That means to plant new stands of different tree species richness, so by planting monocultures, two species mixtures, four species mixtures, on a common ground where the environmental conditions are as constant as possible. So by that, we can more mechanistically test the effects tree diversity has on ecosystem functioning. And there's a number of those experiments also done with trees, similar to those in grasslands, that has been established during the last 15 years in Europe. And those experiments are also included within the Fund of Europe project. A third way to test that question is to use already existing data sets. And in Europe, we have the good situation that all the countries have their so-called national forest inventories. That means foresters go out in the forest to measure the trees out there, and we can use those data sets to look whether we find also a relationship between tree species richness and ecosystem functions like stem wood production in these big existing data sets, and we include those analyses also in the project. Very important for this kind of project is, of course, the dissemination of the results, not only for the scientific communities in scientific papers and journals, but also to a wider audience. Therefore, we have established a so-called knowledge transfer tool, which is a web-based tool to transmit our results to a wider audience, including non-scientists and stakeholders like forest managers, forest owners, and so on.